What we need today more than anything else is to invest in beauty. Because beauty is harmony which comes from chaos. But we invest in chaos. And why we invest in chaos? Because chaos is much more profitable than peace. That's why. So, you see around you, nothing is geared for beauty, from architecture to art to anything. Everything is destroyed.
Yeah.
So, and beauty is a kind of safety valve for people. And music as well. Music, I don't think music is beautiful today. Music is just a way to advertise other things, because music is very powerful as a force, and then through music we can advertise anything we want.
You know, I wonder, you've lived through the 60s. I've lived through the 60s, and you know, we saw that period and all of the upheaval that came out of that period. And there was a lot of music that came out of that period. Some of it was you would probably say was pretty good. Others of it was probably not so good. Do you think that there is an opportunity in this period that we're living in now for some pretty exceptional music?
I don't know. It's been a lot of music. I can say innocent music and maybe manufactured music. And then we went through the manufacturing music for years and years and years and years. And then record companies, they became very, 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 hungry. And, you know, when music becomes a product and the record company becomes an industry, then what do you want to say? You know, something is wrong about that.
And yet you were really a part of that system, weren't you? 50, 51, 52
yes,
recordings?
Yes and no, because when I started with this, I had the impression that by being successful, which unfortunately I've been, I will be able to do things that actually are different. But more successful you become, more prisoner you become to the system, because They don't allow you to do things.
Success didn't buy you in your career more freedom?
No, on the contrary.
Explain that. I would think if you're successful, you get an opportunity to say, no, I don't want to do that. I don't want to go on the road and do 100 cities in 100 days, right?
You become a product, okay? And the record company invests in that. Now, if you are Coca-Cola and you want to change the taste, what's going to happen?
Okay.
You have to keep it until you die. That's why people that actually they are a certain age today, they're still doing the same and they look ridiculous. Because they don't dare changing something. I didn't start in this business because I wanted to become a pop star or a star or whatever. I was trying, to do something, and I had to fight from inside, not from outside. Yeah. But it's very, very difficult. Extremely difficult, because for my interest is music, is not to become famous and to give concerts, as you say.
But the reality is, you became a star. How did it change your life? How did it, as you're telling me now, limit your choices?
It does limit the choices, yes. Choices of expression, yes. Choices to buy, for example, a nice car and a nice house, no. But this is not the goal, this is not the target. The target is when I was really very, very young, I thought that by being successful, I will be able to do more. But no, you can't. I'm in charge of Irish 35 years ago, and it's just like a stamp. You can't get out of it. Let's put it in another way.
Yeah.
You have the music and you have the composer. Who drives who? If, for example, the music drives the composer, the result will be honest and healthy. If the composer drives the music, the result will be dishonest and record business. It's easy. I mean, music is the most important thing. I'm serving music.
I love the stories, and I wonder if some of this
has, which one?
It has become a bit of an urban legend with you.
Which one?
But I love the stories of your youth and you coming to music. And what was it? Was it just sounds that piqued your interest? Were you shown the piano? Did you find the piano? How did that happen? Did music find you? Did you find music?
I don't remember. I just found myself sitting on the piano. And that's it.
And it just happened?
It just happened. And I don't know. Until now, I don't know how to explain that.
Because this is crazy. There are a number of people, okay, who have gone on and had remarkable careers who don't have formal training.
Yeah.
And you're one of those people who has made amazing music throughout a career and can't point to formal training at all. So how do you explain your creative process, this idea of being a vessel for music?
Okay, because we call formal training when comes to music schools. My formal training was nature. My teacher is nature itself. My teacher is music itself.
What does that mean, Vangelis?
I'm talking to you. You are music. I'm music. Everybody's music. It's a mathematical equation. It's the way that you perceive things, that you see things. Doesn't mean that you go into school and you become a musician. Most of the schools, they teach a repertoire, but not music.
Yeah.
Music is a different thing. It's not what we think today. It's one of the most important things that do distort it, like many other important things. You see, we talk about peace, it's distorted. We talk about love, it's distorted. We talk about music, it's distorted. You know, we have to just a little bit think,
yeah.
Maybe at night when we're alone, what is this? What that means, the other one doesn't, what it means, what is music, what is, you say, love, what is all those kind of things, not the cliché things.
So you we'll go think with deeply cliche. About these things?
Yes, because they're the most important.
Have you come to any conclusions about music, about love?
Yes, of course, but I told you, I mean, you asked me, what is the formal training, I told you, it's nature. So in order to say that, the conclusion is that nature music is exactly the same thing. The universe is music. I mean, each one of us is a galaxy. You are a galaxy, I'm another galaxy, you know what I mean? And if you go to microcosm and you go to with a telescope, it's exactly the same thing. Exactly the same thing. So music is not, you know, to pick up a guitar and go and make, as we say, gigs, right? And to be successful. And also another thing that drives me crazy is the obligation to be successful. Why have to be obliged to be successful? Why have to be obliged
because
to...
Because you have to feed a system.
Now you're talking. Why? So you are, if you know those kind of things.
You're bringing me around to your point of view.
Why you make me say that?
Yes.
You know.
This amazing night, the opening of the amphitheater, the Qatara Amphitheater here in Doha. First of all, the invitation and why you agreed to come.
So I decided that because, you know, it's very rare to see a country that appears to be interested for education, art, science, I mean, whatever, you know, culture and all that. And then for me, this is the key for against the crisis today. Because we're talking about crisis all the time, which is a result. And the banking crisis is not so important as the culture crisis. So when you deal with culture and you deal with all these other things, then I think you can manage the rest easier. So, you know, I wanted to support this, and also, I mean, I was very, very impressed that they built this theater, this Greek-style theater, which to me, it's maybe, I mean, I prefer it from these rectangular theaters, and I think it's more alive. It's like a loudspeaker, actually. Yeah. And to be able to see a theater today, like that, new one, it gives hope, because, I mean, in my country we have many, many theaters like that, but this comes from ancient times. But even in my country, we don't build theaters like this, because now the fashion is to build all those, places that you don't feel special when you get in. You don't feel that you're going to see something special. That's it worth the trouble to go there.
My understanding is once you came on board, some of your friends and colleagues came on board as well.
We had a very good team. You know, Angela, Roberto, Jeremy, Ivan Kassar, it was very good.
You were working with Hugh Hudson again.
Oh, yes, that was a great pleasure, because we work after, since Charge of Fire, we never worked together. And he's responsible about the whole filming and the making of and all that, and we've been together. It was really a great pleasure.
What motivates you these days? Clearly, the project in Qatar was something that motivated you. You created original music for the performance. What is it that motivates you these days to create music? What happens? What's that creative spark these days?
Every day I create music. I didn't create music only for Qatar, this period. But the reason that I did that for Qatar is because of this approach. Because for the first time I see a country that shows interest to something which the people needs more than anything else today. Because all the rest and all this misery comes because we don't have what I called before beauty. Quality of life. And quality of life is not money. Quality of life is something else. Like, for example, civilization is not technology. I'm not against technology, of course. But can you imagine high technology without civilized people? How dangerous can be? So I think the moment that Qatar's trying to do something like that, I have to, to support this. Because this is a part of my beliefs.
Yeah.
And that's why, what I can say, although maybe it will never happen, I don't know, I hope that it's going to happen. But in order to happen, we have to help.
Yeah.
Each one of us.
Do you have a need at this point to produce more records? Do you have a need?
No. I compose music every day.
Yeah. Do you have a need to, I don't know, either through the internet or whatever else, to get that out to people, to have them hear it, to have them, maybe share what it is you're feeling, thinking, and influence
this kind of
the kind of world that you'd like to see?
Sharing is very important, but as I said, I don't want to impose. So the moment if you go through the system, then you have to impose things. It's a very, very dangerous game. It's against my principles. Being in a kind of situation which, in one hand, they do exactly the contrary of what you believe, right. And the other hand, you try to keep the balance. It's a very difficult thing.
Right. Speaking of sharing, you know what? I've spent some time with you now. You have a wonderful life. You have.
How do you know?
Well, because can I tell you something? I will tell you, just from the people that I've met around you.
Yeah.
They would lead me, by extension, to believe that you've got this wonderful life. I wonder why you don't share more of that. I mean, you don't play the Facebook, the Twitter. You really don't share much of what I think is a pretty wonderful life of friends, of love, achievements.
Because I think I don't want to flood people with myself. There are enough problems, enough things, and they have maybe other people they love. Doing this, I just prefer to stay, low-key and do my work and compose. And whoever wants to listen to the music, it's okay. And if I can help in any way, Thank you.